In this particular one, we're going to compare a spot healing brush and a clone stamp. Which of the two is better?
Before we dive into this video, please take a minute to subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, and of course, leave comments below of what exactly has resonated with you.
Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. I'm super excited to share this with you. In this particular video, I'm going to show you when to use the clone stamp with removing spots and when to use the spot healing tool when you're removing spots. You ready? Let's get down to this. Let me first flatten it so that we get into this whole thing. First of all, you're first going to work with a clone stamp. How does the clone stamp work? The clone stamp, most of the times, it just copies and pastes. You know, it copies something from around this area, then it pastes it back. While the spot healing tool or the spot healing brush just uses content aware system to remove those small pimples. So when do I use the clone stamp? Now, for the clone stamp, I use it to remove big pimples. That is what I usually use the clone stamp for, and also filling in things like maybe spaces within hair where I would want to put, you know, to fill in gaps. While I use the spot healing brush tool to remove the very tiny spots. So how do I do this? I'll just create a layer here, and I'm just going to call it remove spots. Yeah. Now let's first use the clone stamp just to show you. Now, this is the clone stamp. So how does it work? I just come and select this. So you make sure you have the current layer and below selected so that you get this action happen on the bottom layer. So you come here, current layer and before. So what I usually do, I just put the hardness in around, you know, in the center there, 39% is okay. Then I'll just come reduce the brush. So in order for you to copy, you press the alt key on your keyboard or option key, then you click the plus you want to copy, and then you come and you click here to cover it up. So that is how you use the clone stamp. Still here, you do the same like that. Still. So I use it to remove these very visible pimples, to remove, you know, those blemishes. That is what I use the clone stamp for, like that. Now here, yeah, the reason as to why it's bringing these things is because I did not clone to a closed area. So in order for me to undo, I press Ctrl Z or Ctrl Z to select again, Alt, then I copy. Just like that. Still I come. Still come and remove these. So basically, that is how I use the clone stamp. So how do I use that? Now you see, now for example, this is glue. If I want to cover up this, I just come and clone, for example, this hair, and I cover it up here so that I remove that dirty looking hair, you know. So even here, I just come and get color here, and then I cover this up so that it blends in, you know. So how, when do I use the spot healing brush? So I make sure here I have all layers sampled. I hate editing on the actual pixels, yeah, because once you do a mistake, you just have to redo the whole image, unless here you do it is non-destructive, all the edits happen on the upper layers. The problem with this is that it leaves some patching behind. So that is why it is good to use the clone stamp so that you maintain the texture. This one usually leaves a bit of patching behind. So this one, you don't need to press any alt keys and the like. So basically, that is how I use these two tools. So I'll still just come here and, you know, remove this second layer of eyelashes. You can be very careful when you're doing client pictures, but basically, this is how I use these particular tools. Yes, that's that for today. I just wanted to show you the difference between those two tools. So here is a recap. So when do you use the clone stamp? You use the clone stamp to remove big pimples and those big patches and the blotches. If you want maybe to fill in spaces within hair and the like. Then if you're to remove these small spots as tiny as pores, that is when you use the spot healing brush, because it is very small. The reason as to why you shouldn't use a spot healing brush for big pimples is because it usually leaves a bit of patching behind that is untextured. But a cloned stamp is going to just transfer texture from one space to another. So that is why I use a cloned stamp for removing big pimples. So now, there you have it.
And if you're a beginner photographer or even an advanced photographer and you want to take your retouching to the next level and you want to master retouching, create those high-end fashion magazine quality images, click the first link in the description below and join the Retouching Secrets Masterclass today.